Christmas Day 2004, our filming is finished and we return to our hotel at Mount Lavinia to relax at the beach for our last 2 days in Sri Lanka. But the next day is December 26, and coming from breakfast around 10 a.m., we see the whole Indian Ocean moving back within minutes. It looks absolutely peaceful. However, we know that tidal waves are coming to hit the beach. The sea remains flat like a mirror, yet within a few minutes the water comes back, climbing up the 3 meters high rocks, and also the hotel staff can't believe it when the waves are even flooding the hotel lawn. Some minutes later, the water moves back as fast as it was rising before, only to come back again. Now, sea and beach are full of debris. Through our zoom, we become witness how the poor huts built directly along the coastline direction Colombo are heavily damaged by the waves. Due to aftershock warnings, we wait until the late afternoon before we visit the hotel beach beside the protecting rock. The seafood restaurant is totally destroyed, like many hotels and buildings south of Mount Lavinia. It was nothing but luck that we booked this hotel on a rock and remained uninjured. Here, the beach before and after December 26. Fortunately, the lowland nurseries of Borneo Exotics have not been damaged by the flood. We face 2 more very exciting days until we return to Germany with all of our videotapes for this DVD.
The plants are very lovingly handled, checked off and packed into these rigifoam boxes.
The plants are very lovingly handled. Actually, these pictures show that things are not always easy. It needs a lot of work to multiply up the tissue culture plants and to grow them to this size over many years.
I think we're just in time. I think it's going to rain, isn't it? Actually, if you just pour kerosene on the plants, will that that will go? Yes, go ahead. They're too wet, aren't they?
When Borneo Exotics was founded some 15 years ago, there was no own laboratory. So Rob bought small tissue culture plants from another company for the production under license. Now, after many years of work, the licensor decided that the clones of those particular plants may not longer be used and instructed Borneo Exotics to destroy them all. That means Rob was enforced either to burn the plants or to risk an accusation for license violation. So this video was made for evidence reasons.
Yeah. Oh, I think that's enough. I think everyone can see that the plants wouldn't survive that. years of work. We just continued some time back. We had a couple of stock plants of that, and numerous other things. You can see they're big plants. Area and the speckle one there, I think. This is mostly lowland stuff. Just trying to recall what else there was. Oh, Tomoriana / RH7s. We only had a few of those anyway. These are other Highland species, which have been sitting outside the nursery in their pots for a while, so they're a bit desiccated, but there's a combination of species here, Sanguinea truncata and Spect Vent. In fact, if I zoom, you can probably see there's some Spect Vent pictures in the photo. Quite a few hundred plants here. Not many pictures left, but let's see the characteristic striping of Spect Vent, I think, even on the dead pictures. Enough.
Action.
And now it's time to say goodbye and thank you very much to Rob and Diana for their kind hospitality. This movie became only possible thanks to their great support and cooperation. If you like to read more about Nepenthes, we recommend this new book by the famous author Charles Clark and the discoverer of many new species, Qian Li.
Hunting VG is featuring Borneo exotics. Action.